was sipping this fine wine from lead crystal glasses. Decent white folk who couldn't find their own asses. Suddenly, I started up this wild conversation. All about the problems on Indian reservations. A fella looked at me and said, "That red bastard's got her made. It's giveaway programs and government aid." I said, "Yes, that's why their houses got dirt floors. That must be why their people are dirt poor." He says, "Hold on, let's not get enough. Explain where you're from before you start talking tough." I said, "I growed up with a Sioux in a northern Cheyenne. Proud Navajo, wound a man down. They taught me about pain, they taught me about hunger. They taught me them puppies could be good for supper, yes sir." He says we drove through them while they're all such a mess. Beer cans everywhere, whoa, God bless. I said, "Yes, we replaced that Rocky Mountain spring water with that good old barley pop fire water. And them cans shine like trinkets down there in the ditches. All of that luminol's bound to be worth riches. And it's really kind of neat the way they toss it to the side. So the wealth can be shared by the whole tribe." Now we only took their land and their pride and their children. We only took away that good buffalo living. But what chaps my butt most is when a do-gooder's come and they're gonna right all his wrongs that's been done. Gonna make up for a century of suffering with Babe Ruth candy bars and bottles of buffers. Well, I think it's time we ended this conversation all about the problems on Indian reservations. I drank too much wine from y'all's fancy glasses. It's obvious you can't find your own asses. You best keep your eye on a reservation, boy. I'll take your wampum and run. You best keep your eye on a reservation, boy. I'll guzzle all that Rothschilds and run. You best keep your eye.